Hi everyone, you're going to be joining me today to start our farmyard set. All these little things in the picture here, you will be able to see how it's made in a set of 6 videos. This is our first one and it's the pig. So you start out with a beige peachy colored cylinder, a little fat little one. You don't want it too long. And all I did here was I pressed up to make it curve upwards. So that way our little pig is going to be sitting on his rump with his chest and his front paws up in the front legs, standing up straight. And you want to make sure you keep them nice and round while you're doing this. Okay, and in order to attach the head, I use a piece of dried spaghetti. I use this in place of toothpicks with all of my decorations. Either that or I'll use a lollipop stick or popsicle sticks, never toothpicks, because kids can eat them and choke or get hurt. Now, in order to make the back feet, which is what we're doing here, you're going to make 2 thin, you know, little pink rectangles and cut little triangles out of the tips. Those are going to become the back hooves. And once you get them cut out, curve them around, smooth them out, make them rounded because our little piggy is very round. He's not very sharp. And there you go. Now I'm going to cut off the extra pieces because they just need to show the little back feet. You don't need a lot of legs showing in the back. And I smoosh down on the edge, on the back edge there, and that's where we're going to tuck it under his butt. So I'm going to get some water on my paintbrush. I have a little paintbrush. It's nothing special. Paint a little bit of water onto it, and then just set his rump right on top of him. You want the feet to be facing outward, but also forward, so at an angle. So that way, you know, it's just cuter that way. That's really all it is. All right, there you go. And the next step we're going to do is we're going to make his tail after I finish tweaking him. There we go. To make the tail, you're going to take a little piece and roll it out nice and thin and long, as long as you want, as long as it's not ridiculous, and then just twist it into a coil. And that's his little curled piggy tail. And again, to attach it to the back, a little bit of water on his rump with my paintbrush. Press it into place, and there you go. He's got his tail. He's looking good. To do the front legs, you're going to roll out 2 cylinders. I press down on the front and bend it outward so it looks like a foot. So it has that kind of a bend and a foot look to it. You'll see it here. See? And then again, like you did with the back feet, you're going to cut a triangle out of the toe to give him his little hoof. And again, like you did with the back, smooth it out, round it out, make it not so sharp and edgy. Make sure your tips are nice and pointy. And because it's going on to the front of his body, we're going to carve away some of the extra on the back, because otherwise his legs would stick out in front of his body and it would look weird. But cut it out at an angle so it slopes, and that way it'll be able to fit up against his body. Attach it with a little bit of water and do it for the other leg too. Now for his head, I just took a little round ball, and as you can see, I'm pressing down flat on the front and then kind of shaping the sides and pressing down on the front again. I want the front to be a little bit flat where his snout will be, and then it recesses a little bit back where his eyes will end up going. And to attach the head, just like you've been doing over and over again, add a little bit of water around the spaghetti stick and press it down into place. Now about the spaghetti stick, do not use anything but regular old spaghetti. If you use whole wheat or gluten-free or something like that, it will absorb the moisture from the gum paste and get all soft and soggy, and it won't hold its shape. So you want to use just regular old spaghetti. Now to make his little snout, I got a little dark pink oval. It's actually just regular pink. I just used a lot of it. And using the back of my paintbrush, press 2 little nostril holes, a little bit of paint, and press it into place. And when you do this, most likely you'll move it or smoosh it, which I did, which is why I'm trying to reshape it here. And the color of the pig, if you're interested, is actually called creamy peach. It's not pink, it's actually creamy peach. And I only used a little bit of it because that color goes a long way. Now I made some eye holes, but I didn't put his eyes in because I don't know why. And I went right to his ears. I rolled out a long oval and cut off the end of the oval, and then folded it over on itself. A little bit of water onto the side of his head, and you can just press it into place. Now, don't put the ears on top. They have to go toward the side of his head, because otherwise he's going to look like a cat or a dog or something like that with ears on top of his head. So do the same thing for the other ear. Cut off the end of an oval and bend it in place. The eye, as you can see, is super easy. Two little black dots with a little touch inside the eye sockets of water, and press them into place. Make sure you don't use too much water in those eye sockets, because black leaks its color when it's wet very much. Be careful. Here you have your cute little pig. If you like this video and you want to see how to make the rest of the farm set, there are going to be 5 other videos coming out that you can follow along with. If there's something you'd like to see, comment below.